Hello. You're reading this message. I have been kidnapped. I'm being held hostage for 5,000 Twinkies.
Twinkle, twinkle. Alright.
So what are we doing here?
Oh, not necessary. I always bring my own. So, what we're doing, I think we're going to start some segments about Oregon beers. I'll give them that little known fact about Oregon breweries.
Little known fact. Oh, that there's more breweries, well, at least in Portland per capita, than there are some countries in Oregon. I didn't know.
There's a lot to review. Lots to review. And I know I just said, I'm not drinking, but there was an arrangement with my buddy. He wasn't supposed to smoke with me. But the arrangement was to drink for social occasions or special occasions. And this is being presented to you. Presented to you! And how good this is. Oh, he got it. He's got it, folks. Lagunitas. Oh, Sonoma. Farmhouse. I probably said it wrong. Say it right then.
Sonoma. And it's pronounced B-Red.
Yeah, sure.
B-Red.
Sure. Boom. That's the choosing. My name is Brett. His name is Mark. But he didn't find a Mark beer.
Not, but I did find this Ecliptic Capella Porter.
Stout. 11.3%. Oh, so good. So good.
Yeah.
Let me hear that smell. Yeah, that's pretty stouty.
Is there stuff like tasting notes on it or it says like?
Well, what is it? 5.2%. A little weaker.
It's got a little description on the side.
Oh,
a little description. Capella is named after a bright star in the constellation of.
There you go.
Sweet dark malt aromas are followed by a nice medium body. Chocolate and caramel notes meld with just a touch of roast. Collection of American hops, Nugget, Chinook, Centennial, and Cascade brighten this lively porter. It has a World Beer Cup 2016 gold as well. Really like a cup of pink Starburst IPA.
Well, okay, with our Farmhouse series is a showcase of the sometimes funky, sometimes rustic, always limited fine ales from the Lagunitas Breweries. I love Lagunitas. This particular Brett Stout was fermented with a slight red wine barrels for up to 4 years. The results is 100% pure barrel aged bliss, smooth, tart, and sultry. That's ishness. Finally aged, finally ready to share. Try one now and grab another to age a little longer. Or not. Life is uncertain. It sure is. That's why we have to test these beers before we die. So, you know, you guys need this feedback, you know? Yeah, we gotta know the good beers from the bad beers. We got just literally hundreds, maybe thousands. So we gotta try this. Each brewery's got more than one significant brand that they recommend. So. Alright.
So we say we try it and stop HQ and do something cool.
That does kind of taste like a wine. That's interesting. A little bit. Wow. Yeah. At almost 12%.
Can you tell it's strong?
Oh, yeah. It tastes like a wine. Wow. Yeah, it's like, I think it's only like a hint of stuff, mostly wine. Woo! Yeah,
so you have imperial stout aging that one.
Yeah, definitely has it. Give it a try, my friend. Alcohol feels good. Don't be afraid to share a drink.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That's pretty
very
wine.
Like wine for
it. See?
That's really good for it.
This has your a little hoppy taste to it.
Yeah, I'm getting a little bit of like glass taste, like a glass, or like a taste from the glass or something. Mm. Kind of like that. Almost like sometimes you get a taste. Nice, very nice.
In case you don't know, we got some redneck renovation going on here for our camera view for you guys. got two chairs stacked on each other. Got a USB cable wrapped around my phone, filming it right there, you know, with this. Oh, yeah. I'm a guy that the hell out of that. Yes, it's not going nowhere. You can have an earthquake right now. You're still going to get this footage, all right? All right.
That's how dedicated you are to this craft.
Oh, yeah. To this craft.
Yes, indeed.
Wow. Yeah, that's more wide than stout.
I'm surprised, though, because it actually like works pretty well.
It does. I just wasn't expecting that. I was expecting more of the stout taste. Nope, it's totally overpowered by the wine.
Well, there you go.
If you want wine in disguise of beer, get my stuff. My name. You should totally, have me slogan for you guys.
Contact.
Absolutely. Come on, guys. Yes. Get sliced.
Oh, yes.
Just so you know, off the camera, I'm not allowed to drink. So, this lovely, presentation. It's because, you know, I'm feeling. But since the camera's off, yep, I have to be a good boy.
It makes it sound like you're not allowed to drink, like, by a court order or
something. Oh, man. It was a bro-ship con, you know? You gotta honor the bro-ship pacts.
That's right.
Yes. But, yeah, final thoughts tonight. I feel like I get your typical hoppy beer taste here, and like, wow, yeah. Wine. This is legit wine with a hint of stout.
This one's not too hoppy. You do have a... Definitely get some of that...
I'd like to try that Starburst you tell.
Yeah, that one's
very good. We can step up our games. You know, I wish this was in a small bottle. Fortunately, it was single by itself. Not that cheap. We're looking about almost $12 for this guy. But then again, what store was that we went to? I mean, not to throw the stores under the bus, but certain ones are a little more pricey than others. But this one definitely had all the microbrews in it. So.
Well, I think liquor in general is a little more expensive. Alcohol is more important.
Well. And even how is that how you're supposed to say right here? Say la du ni tus. La du ni tus.
And similarly, instead of Oregon, they'll say Oregon.
Oregon, yes.
Very important.
All you other people out there not from the state, don't say Oregon. It's like, that's weird. We'll look at you weird if you say it that way. Come on.
Oh, yeah, you mean from living in Oregon?
You want us to say Arkansas instead of Arkansas?
Yeah.
We know that drives you guys nuts.
Illinois.
Yeah. Come on. Come on. But let's keep filming so I can keep drinking. No. We should have legit ended it, but you know, final thoughts. It's pretty damn good. It's pretty damn good. I recommend it.
I like
the Lagunitas brands, you know, a little brown sugar, a little something something. Those are all really good. I can do another live review of that too, even though I know what they taste like. maybe he hasn't tried it, probably. Right?
Well, I've tried the brown sugar, so it's not that.
It's like, it takes a certain taste for these strong beers. I like a good strong beer.
Just load mine up with some basil.
Oh, yeah. I'll look at a beer, first thing I'll look at is the percent, you know. I'm all about results.
Efficiency.
But I was on this one strictly because of the name. I was thrilled to see the percentage, man. That's awesome. Thrilled. It totally speaks to me.
That's how you know it's your beer, is because it's got the 11%.
Oh,
and it's got 8 minus.
11.3. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm happy. I feel my cheeks getting a little rosy. Are they getting rosy?
A little bit.
Oh, yeah.
You are not a lightweight, right?
No, but I can feel things flow through the blood. It's going through the blood. It's not taking over, but showing its results. It happens. So pink. Going to be pink after that little slap. A little bit, not much yet, but it's slowly getting there. I'm a pink skinny guy, you know?
I'm just hairy.
Oh, hi, Harry. I'm brown. Very good, very good. Dad jokes get ready for those. I'm always full of those.
Woo!
For something. Mm-hmm. So, you know, this is brought to you by Lagunitas and
Eclipse. Capella Porter, and we got the Farmhouse Brett stuff.
Free advertising. You're welcome. All right, so last thoughts for, you know, we'll probably do some more beer reviews, stuff we've never tried. Maybe some other content like games. You know, we could smash. Bros Ultimate. Where were you going? You just said games, remember?
Jeez.
Anyways,
thanks for watching.
Y'all stay awesome. I know I would say hit the like and subscribe, but it's like we're nowhere near that point yet, folks. We're lucky if we get any kind of algorithm that you see us. But whatever. I'm gonna turn up the camera because I'm saying bye. This guy's gonna say bye. Bye.